Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how you can create your own model for Marvelous Designer. So most of you have always asked this question, how you can get their own model. So today I'm going to show you how you can get your own model for Marvelous Designer using MakeHuman. So to start, we can open MakeHuman. So this is the default interface for MakeHuman. So for those that don't have MakeHuman, check the description below and you can find the link on where you can download MakeHuman, and on the website you can find more information there. So this is default interface, and this model right now is neither male or female. So when you check gender, when you take the gender to the extreme left, it becomes a woman, and if you take it to the extreme right, it becomes a man. So today I'll be working on a female model, so I'll take it to the extreme left. So here under age, you can take it to the extreme left and it becomes a baby, depending on the fashion line you're designing in Marvelous Designer. So depending on the clothing line, you can work with the age. So this is for a baby, this is for a teenager, this is for a middle-aged woman, and this is for an elderly woman. So here in age, you can decide the kind of model you're working with. So today I'll be creating a middle-aged woman, maybe within her 25. So here in muscle, you can create either a no muscle model or a muscular model. So this is like in cases where you're designing a sporting clothing line, like you need a model who has abs and stuff like that, so you can use this parameters for her. So I'll just leave it at default. So here in weight, you can take it to the extreme left and the model looks skinny and anorexic, and you can take it to the extreme right and she looks a little bit chubby. So I think I'll just leave it at the default. Yeah, here in height, you can either go short or you can go tall, so I'll just leave it at the default too. Proportion is her body size. You can either go all fat or you can go all sexy and all sporty. So I think I'll just leave it at default too, not too fleshy, not too sporty. So this is my favorite part. So this here, you can choose the kind of skin color you want. If you want it to be all African, then you go all African. So when you take it to the extreme left, it unchecks Asian and Caucasian, so your model is all African. So to see what that really looks like, you can go to rendering and scene. There you can see what your model skin color actually looks like. So I tried this once and it was too dark in Marvelous Designer, so I don't think I'll try this again. So I'll go back to modeling, and if I take it to Asian, it unchecks African and it unchecks Caucasian. So let's go to rendering and see what the skin color looks like. So it's all whitish, kinda. And the face presentation is all Asian. So I don't really want to do Asian now. Maybe some other time. So if I take it all Caucasian, I really like Caucasian because, not just because of Caucasian, but because of the skin color. I love the outlook. So let's go to rendering and see what it looks like. You see, it's not too dark, it's not too white, so it's just there, like there. So I usually go for an Afro Caucasian, just a little bit of African to her, so it doesn't look so exaggerated. So I just a little bit of Afro Caucasian. So that's just it for me. So yes, so after the main parameters, you can go to the gender. Here you can set the breast size, genitals. Now going to the breast size, you can change the breast size, the firmness, vertical position of the breast, the horizontal position, pointiness and nipple size, all that. So if I change the breast size to this, you can see it increases the size of the breast. So this is a little bit too much for me, so I think this is fine for me. So firmness makes the breast look all firm. So since we're dealing with a middle-aged woman, so we should expect that her breast should be firm. But if you're working with an elderly woman, you will not be working with a firm breast, because it's expected that an elderly woman should have a little bit of a sag to her breast. So I think this is fine. Vertical position, it positions the breast how high or how low you want it to be. So I think just here will be fine. Yeah, This is fine by me. Horizontal distance, it sets how far apart the breasts are to each other. So this is awkward. So, but I think this is okay. This is fine by me. Yeah. You must be wondering how I'm doing the rotating thing. Just hold down the left click and rotate. You hold down the left click and roll it. So to however, that's how you rotate and make human. So if you go to pointiness, I think we work better with the side view. It shows it better. So when you set it to the extreme right, you find out that it becomes all pointy. And if you use this for your clothes is going to be all pointy and you lose the shape of the cloth on your model. So I think we should just take it down. Take it down to be moderate. I think this would be nice. Yeah, this is cool. So breast volume, it sets the volume of the breast, how big or how, you can see how it increases. So this works better for me if I'm dealing with a pregnant model, like when I'm designing a clothing line for pregnant women. So I use the pregnant breast volume. So it increases the breast volume to equate the pregnancy. So now I don't think this might look nice because she's not pregnant. But if I take it down a little bit, she looks cool. I think this is fine. This is okay for me. Now here in nipple size. Nipple size works on the areola. It increases or decreases the areola. You can see how it does that. Well, you know, we don't really need an exaggerated nipple for the model because you don't need your model having a shooting out dot on her when you dress her up in your garment. So even the nipple point increases the pointiness of the nipple, so we don't really need that. So you can just make it have that feel that she has a nipple. So that's it for gender. Here in face, you can set the shape of the skull, the shape of the face, and the age, how wrinkled or how smooth the face is. But I'm not working on that now because this is not a tutorial for Make Human. So here in torso, you can, here on the right side of the interface, you can find torso, you can find the hip, you can find the stomach, buttock, pelvis. Now each of these you click has a different setting to it, so you can set the hip and change the scale just as the description shows there. If you change it, it increases or decreases the scale. So you just have to I'll undo that. So you just have to work with what works best for you. So basically what I'm going to work on here is show you the stomach and the buttock. So here in the stomach, and you have pregnancy shape. In pregnancy shape, you can set how pregnant you want your model to be. So let's set the side view so you can see it better. So if you take it to the extreme, you can see it bulges out. So here you can have a pregnant woman depending on the intensity of the pregnancy. So that is how you can set it here. If you take it back, she has a very flat tummy. But if you take it out a little bit, she looks pregnant. So I'll just leave it here so that she doesn't look pregnant and she doesn't look non-pregnant. She's just there. So here in navel bump, you can set the depth, how deep you want the navel bump to be. So we don't really need that. It's not so important here. Here in navel position is how high or how low the navel is. So this is okay for me. I think this is fine. So here in buttock, this is my favorite part. I love to take it to the extreme because I love my models to look curvy and my skirt to look all fitting on my model. So I think this is a little bit too much. Yeah, I think this is fine. This is okay for me. Pelvis, you can still set the genital volume. Like if we left this at the center by default, when you're working with these genitals, you find out that it either projects as a penis or a vagina because it doesn't have a defined male or female topology. So I'll just take it back because we don't need this to be all bold. Like you have your model wearing a swimming suit and you have it like having a bulgy vagina, so we don't need that. So I'll just take it to the extreme. Now here in pelvis muscle tone, let's see I needed to notice what it does. If I take it to the extreme, it takes it up. And if I take it to the extreme left, it sags the butt. This could work for an elderly woman, but for a middle-aged woman, hell no. It doesn't work. So I'll just leave it at default. I won't do that. So I think this is fine. This is perfect for a middle-aged woman. So here in arms and leg, you can find that the right side of the interface, you find right hand, left hand, and so forth. So you can set all that the way you want it to be. So when you've done all this, you want her to have her hair, like the hair type. So you don't want her to come in bald like this. So you can go to geometrics. So if you go to geometries, you find eye. Here in eye, it's set by default in high poly eye, so you can leave it at that. Hair, you can set the type of hair. So to select, because here is male and female, so you can just check female and it's select, like it brings out the, like only the hair categories for female. So you have short bob hair, yeah. So here you have a longer bob hair. Here you have hair with braid. So you don't need this because the braid is too long and it's going to interfere with your cloth. So you don't go for this. I can't say you can't because you might want to, but I don't think it's okay because when you're simulating your cloth, it will interfere with your cloth. Likewise, this is a long hair. I don't think you should go for this, but you can go for a ponytail because it's short and will not interfere with your cloth. And this is a short one. This is my favorite hair. So I usually go for this. So I'll go for this today. And here in teeth, we don't really need this. I'll explain more of this if you are interested in an in-depth tutorial about Make Human. I'll talk more on this. But for now, I'll just show you how to create a model. So here in eyebrow, you just select the eyebrow of your choice. So I usually go for this one. So see a nice eyebrow, and you go for an eyelash. Just I need something exaggerated. Yeah, I need a sassy model. So this is fine by me. And here in material, you can find a detailed skin color look, but this is like a defined, like young Asian female, young Caucasian female, middle-aged Caucasian. So I wanted an Afro-Caucasian, so here you might not find that. So that's why I usually go for the previous one I did. So I'm not gonna do anything here. So here in eye color, here you set the eye color, where you click on eye, you set the eye color. So I'll just go for blue eyes. So you're not going to see an effect here, but when you take her into Marvelous, you see the effect of the eye color. So I think that's basically it. We've selected everything. Now here in pose and animate, we'll like to attach a bone to it so that it can grab the motions you attach to it. So I usually go for default because it has a head rig to it. If you check CMU, it doesn't have a head rig. So this one has a head rig to it, so that's why I usually go for this one has a detailed finger rig and all that. So I think this is better. And here in poses, you can find different poses like benchmark, fight, in cases that you're designing a clothing line for a Tai Chi kind of people, you can need this fight pose for your models. But I don't really need a pose, so I won't go for it. Like if you select this fight, you can see your model take the pose. If you select fly, you can see your model takes the pose. If you select standing, you can see your model takes the pose. Standing too, you can see your model takes the pose. So I'll just go with none because I don't need any of that. If you go to expression, now here in expression, the left interface, you're gonna see different forms of expression: anger, interest, boredom. So usually I go for delight because that's where you have the smile. So if I select delight, it highlights all the smile expressions Make Human has. So I usually go for smile too because it's just moderate. Yeah, because I don't need a mean looking model. So I think that's fine. So I'll just go to export. I'll just export my model and export. Now we have Collada, we have FBX, we have OBJ, Augur 3D, and STL. So Marvelous Designer actually accepts the first three. So I can either export as a Collada file, as an FBX file, or as an OBJ. They will definitely come into Marvelous Designer. So I'll export it as a Collada file. And you can notice that this blinking cursor here, there is no name or file location for our model. So I'll click on this box here to select a file location to save it. So I'll save it on my desktop and I'll call her Jane. Save. So now I can export. So you can see it's reading, it's exporting it down here. So I think it's done. So let's see how that goes. So in my next tutorial, I'll import her into Marvelous Designer and show you how our model will function in Marvelous Designer. So if you're interested, come with me to the next tutorial and subscribe for more tutorials. See you in the next tutorial.